I'm going to talk about an 8-wire blower motor, commonly installed in both DC inverters and, more frequently, in non-DC inverters. I'll give you all the information you need about this motor. You may notice that there are 4 wires present in the connector, but in addition to that, there are 2 more wires, making a total of 6 wires. Additionally, there's another connector with 2 more wires, bringing the total number of wires to 8. This motor is quite different from other motors because it doesn't have electronic control. Instead, its speed is manually controlled by the electronic board directly, without measuring the speed. It merely switches from one relay to another to control the speed. I have another motor here, which I've already opened to save time. Look at the back side. There's no electronic circuit here. On the front side, you can see that there's only a rotor and coil, and nothing else to control its speed. The speed is controlled through these wires. Now the wires will be reduced, and their usage will be minimized. Will these wires be cut? Instead, you will be informed about their purpose. And as you are gradually informed about the purpose of these wires, the number of cables will decrease. These 2 wires have the same yellow color and are installed in the same connector. If we look at the motor, after the yellow wire, there is a white-colored wire before it, and a joint has been made with this wire. These 2 wires are for the thermostat, which senses the motor's temperature. If the motor reaches 95 to 100 degrees, it will trip and stop operating. So, we've addressed 2 wires. Next, let's look at the next 2 wires. These are usually connected to capacitors, one wire for the neutral and the other for the start winding. So that accounts for 2 more wires. Now, we have 4 remaining wires. One is for neutral, and the other 3 are for high, medium, and low speeds. Next, I'll explain the winding inside this motor and how it's controlled, which will make it easier for you to connect any motor you encounter. There's also a sticker on the motor that provides this information, but if the sticker isn't there, I'll tell you how to understand the connections. To understand the windings, you'll need to test them with a multimeter or a series board. The company has brought out 6 wires from this motor. Even if there were only 5 wires, the same functions could still be achieved. However, since there are 6 wires, we need to figure out what the remaining wires are for. The company has made 2 wires common at one point, so we need to identify which ones are common. For that, you'll need a multimeter. You can set the multimeter to continuity mode or check in ohms mode, but continuity mode is easier if you are less experienced. Inside this motor, there are coils, and these coils have their own resistance. Wherever the resistance is high, the multimeter will not beep in continuity mode, and where there is low resistance, like in wires, the continuity beep will work. So now I'll show you by checking it. But first, I will intentionally show you an incorrect method so that you can understand better because I already know about these wires. I'm doing this just to explain to all of you. I will slightly test it wrong. I have connected the red probe to the blue wire, and now I will check the other probe with all the wires. First, I will check this wire, and there's no beep sound coming from it. Even with this connection, there is no sound. However, the resistance value is showing here, which is 235 ohms, but no beep sound is coming along with it. The next wire also shows resistance, and the next one too. None of the wires have made a beep sound. This means the beep sound will be present on some other wires. Now, I will check with the brown wire. I've placed the second probe on this connector, and the ohm value is showing here. On this second wire, only the value is being displayed. On the third wire, the value is also showing, but no beep sound. Now look at this point, the value is showing with very low resistance, and the beep sound is also coming. This means that this brown wire and the white wire here are both common and joined at the same point. Now it's clear to us that the brown and white wires are common. The neutral will be connected to the white wire, and the capacitor will be connected to the brown wire. So I will go ahead and connect the capacitor in the diagram. We all know that when a motor is manufactured, it has both a starting winding and a running winding, and only then can it operate properly. Let's take a look at how to identify the connections among the 6 wires. First, when it comes to the running winding, one side of it will always be connected to the neutral. The first thing we need to find is the common point. To do that, we need to find the point with the lowest resistance value. Set your meter and check the resistance values. In this case, the lowest value is 294 ohms, then 340 ohms, and then 358 ohms. Let's also check with the blue wire. And here we get a reading of 530 ohms with the neutral. This means that the black wire has the lowest resistance and is therefore the common point. It's connected here, meaning these two wires are joined together. This confirms that these two are connected. Now, the running winding usually has two additional windings attached to it. These two windings allow the motor's speed to be controlled. We've found the common point with the lowest resistance, which connects to the start point, and the other point is the high-speed position because we need to install the line here. The black wire represents the high-speed connection. Next, we need to find the capacitor wire because the motor won't start without it. The neutral is connected to the running winding, and here is the starting winding, which needs to be connected to the capacitor. So this means that we should be getting the resistance of both the run and start windings. And here we have the highest resistance value. Let's check the blue wire, which has a resistance of 530 ohms, the highest value. So the blue wire will be installed here. Now we have the common wires and the high speed point with the lowest resistance. Moving on to the medium speed connection, let's check for the second lowest resistance value between the white wire and the medium point. The red wire shows a resistance of 342 ohms. The orange wire has a resistance of 358 ohms. So this means that this point is for medium speed, which is the red wire. After this, one wire was left, which we've already checked, and its resistance was 358 ohms. So this will be the low speed wire, which is the orange wire. Now the question arises, how do we control these three connections? If all three connections receive power at the same time, the motor won't work properly. So, how is this achieved? Let me show you on the PCB. There are relays installed, and here's the point where the fan connects, and this is where the motor I showed you is installed. Here, we have these relays installed, and this particular trace is the common point for the relays. These relays are interconnected and handle the switching. The microcontroller controls them, turning one relay on while turning the other two off. If a different speed is required, the other two will turn off, and another one will turn on. This is how the speed operates. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.